Hey everybody, how you doing? This is Kyle with Glass Aquatics. This is Mike. Mike's going to take us through our feeding process here at the store, how you should use your food to your advantage, being that you want to switch from one type of food to the other throughout the week. It's better for your fish, and he's going to explain why.
Okay, so like Kyle said, every 3 to 4 days, I do a mass feeding where I combine all the small foods and the large foods, and I do a basking. So I'm going to take you through a bunch of our products that we use on that day. So first, it's garlic. I'll always use garlic. It's going to entice fish to feed. It's going to have many benefits to their health and keep their immune system up. So garlic's first. Then we do marine snow. Then I have reef roids. And there's some process to getting that all mixed up and made into a slurry. And on top of that, then we do our phytoplankton. Marine cuisine, mysis shrimp, and brine shrimp. The three foods, frozen foods, are actually the large basis of the meats. So after we put in our large foods, we mix it all together, and you end up with a large slurry of food, which is a crazy amount of food to feed to an aquarium. And I do this every 3 to 4 days. Okay, so when we feed our massive amount of food, I start by doing a process called basking. So I turn all the flow off to my aquarium. I don't recommend you do that. You don't have a super huge amount of coral, and you don't necessarily have to turn off your system. So, and you won't ever feed your tank in the manner that I do, but basking your tank is absolutely okay. So I basically go through and I disperse the food all through the tank, and I have a lot of it. So we're going to have multiple turkey basters full of food, and once you start feeding like this, if you do, you'll see that your feeder tentacles will all start coming out. Everybody will be very active. All the hermit crabs for sure. Any fish you have in your tank will be absolutely active. And just to let you know, I purchased quite a few of frags that were actually on their way out and not doing well. And since they came here and I've been putting this method of feeding into place, I've actually brought a lot of them back. Basking my corals, but I've still got a bunch of the store to go. So this is our display tank, and I'll actually feed it quite a bit also, but I won't ever turn the flow off on this one because I don't want to end up with an issue with overflowing a sump or forgetting it because it's not on a easily reached switch. So I am direct feeding and also basking quite a bit of food in here. And I do that, like I said, every 3 to 4 days. I'll do my tanks quite a bit of food just to make sure everybody's getting plenty of food. We have a starfish in here that is on the mend. He lost his entire cap, and I'll make sure that he's got a lot of food here to eat. And starfish are very resilient in some cases. And he's been with us for over 10 years. And then I'll direct feed our anemone here. And then some direct feed to our corals. Chalices and go-to cups. Brain coral in here. And this is just an extra large feeding of food, and it doesn't take place of your normal feeding that you would do. Then I move on to my fish.
Okay guys, this has been our video on mass feeding. I hope that you learned something. Remember to check back every week. We're going to be making weekly videos like this. If you want to see something on a specific topic or a specific product we could review or tell you something about, whether you should use it, what do we think about it, we'll be doing that. All the products that we showed and talked about, there's going to be a link in the description down below to our website where you can get all that stuff. I just want to thank Mike for teaching us all about mass feeding, and I look forward to seeing him on the next video.
Later.
Official Nation. I'm going to start putting that in all the videos. Like, I'm going to make it a thing.
Oath.
Official Nation.
Thanks for seeing us this week.
That's terrible. Okay.
I'm just going
to... So, well, that's a good place to stop.